This is my first tamper. It was used to tamp pre-ground, Robusta-laden, Italian-roasted coffee into the basket of a domestic gadget that I was demonstrating in a department store. It was not a good tamper. The first proper tamper I bought was David Schirmer's Ergo Packer. I saved up a lot of money, and I was somewhat enamored with him because he just seemed to have answers. Sadly, it was intercepted by customs, and I never managed to get hold of it. I couldn't afford a replacement. A few months later, I ended up doing what most people had done. I bought a Reg Barber tamper. Now, I wanted a tamper because I wanted to feel like I had a craft, and that I had tools that represented that craft. I wanted an object that legitimized me, and also what I did for a living. It was to be the first of many. As you look at the evolution of tampers in the last 10 or 15 years, it does hold a mirror to the progress and evolution of the coffee industry itself. Early on, tampers became a kind of focal point for experimentation. There were great hopes of unlocking flavor through the design of the bases, be it convex or concave, concentric rings, or perfectly flat, perfectly fitting surfaces. All of these were explored with a sense of excitement and hope, and there was legitimacy in those early experiments. Slowly, tamper design began to drift, lose that initial purpose. They became items of jewelry, of self-expression, and then items of novelty. Soon, material became more important than function. I look at my collection of tampers now, and I see mostly memories of times in my life or of the people who gave me generous gifts. This particular tamper is from my Barista Championship win in Tokyo, a tamper both stolen and earned. For the finals, I had somehow managed to forget my tamper. Close to the prep area, there was a table full of Reg Barber tampers. With every intention of returning it, I grabbed one, and I used it on stage. And straight afterwards, I went back to confess and to return it, and they gave it to me. It remains a nice reminder of the truth of the chaos of that experience, but also of an amazing day in my life. So why am I telling you this? Why am I thinking about tampers? It would be premature to say that tampers are about to be made obsolete, but I think the writing is on the wall. Technology is coming. I won't be sad to see the act of tamping go. It's easy to make a mistake. At best, you just ruin a cup of coffee. At worst, you damage your body. I have more tampers than I'll ever need, and yet I can't let them go. Perhaps they're doomed to end up like a box of old photographs that you dig out from time to time and look through and reminisce. And maybe that's what I'm doing right now, digging through that box and telling a story or two. And maybe in the future I'll dig that box out again and tell some more stories.